Hello student, welcome to your Pedia Education. So in the continuation of the series where we keep on updating and informing you people about various opportunity in foreign admissions and jobs. So today I am here with one such more opportunity, that is again with NTNU, and that is in integrated circuit design. Fine. So it is with NTNU, Norwegian University of Science and Technology, the Department of Electronic System has a vacancy for PhD candidate in ultra low power integrated circuit design for cell powered Internet of Things. This is a very important term, cell powered Internet of Things. Fine. So let us, before going ahead, discuss in brief about this project. What is this all about? In what direction they are going to take step ahead to make the Internet of Things self-sustainable and self-powered? And what they are expecting from you as an aspirant or candidate. See, if we listen the term Internet of the Things, so it means a very smart technology. You know, because of interrelation or connection between the physical world and digital worlds, they have made the technology and things surrounding us very smart. There are thousands, lakhs, millions of devices, they are interconnected even from, various remote locations. But still, the real potentials of IoT is yet to be explored. See, what is the basic requirement of any operator or any device? That is the energy requirement. How we are going to energize it? How we are going to make that, life of that device long lasting? More energy is available for more duration, the device will last. Otherwise, can we make some technology or tools, and can we make research in that direction that we can make that device a self-powered or self-sustainable? So once we are able to do this, then we can really explore the true potential of this IoT. See, in remote location, there are so many remote sensor and embedded device in IoT systems, which are operated by the battery. Million lakhs of device operated with the battery. You can imagine every day battery replacement, how much it's going to cost and maintenance. So keeping these all point in mind, there is a straightforward need of self-powered IoT devices or self-sustainable IoT devices. So how we can do this? We can do that in various ways. We can do that by doing the efficient energy harvesting. We can do that by reducing the power consumptions. We can do that, by following the low voltage operations. So what sort of the technology and, skills you are going to implement at the direction, at the, level of the circuit designing, at the level of the device selection, and what are the various algorithms to do the efficient energy harvesting you can work on. So this is the direction in which they are, going to take the step ahead. Right? See, there are so many non-conventional sources of energy surrounding us in the environment from where we can utilize the energy, harvest the energy, and make it into the usable form. Although that energy might be very less, but there are so many sensors and electronics devices which deals in the low power applications, so they can contribute effectively there. We can reduce the power consumptions. We can prefer the low voltage operation. But for that, how our device characteristics are not going to affect it, we need to make sure that in that direction, what work we can do. So these all are the learning skills for the new aspirant who are currently doing their M.Tech in any of the respective institute and B.Tech. They can think these objectives as their major project or research project for the ahead, so that they can bridge their journey easily with this sort of the institution further if are willing to proceed the PhD. Fine. So this is basically the brief description about this project. So now see what are the different deadlines associated with this project. Okay. See, the very first thing is the duration of the PhD employment is 36 months, which is almost 3 years, right? The starting gross salary is 491,200 in their respective currency per year. So this is the very first information, means you are going to paid for that. This is kind of employment for you people. Is it clear? Now let's move further. Now there are certain duties of the position, because you are employed here, then what sort of the duties you need to perform? So they have mentioned commit to the described project in cooperation with supervisor aiming to finish the PhD degree in a timely manner. Keep in mind. Fine. Second thing is undertaking the necessary courses as a part of the PhD program. Next is submitting an application for admission and research plan no later than 3 months after the employment. And next is conducting high quality research and report progress on a regular basis and in agreement with the supervisors. So these are the some of the duties they have mentioned you need to follow, right? Next, if we go ahead, there are certain required selection criteria. The first, education requirement. You must have a 5 year of higher education or education equal to the grade requirement or B or higher, that is on the based of the NTNU grading scales. You can visit their website. There is detailed information mentioned about this. And this 5 year of higher education include your BSc and MSc, or you can say your bachelor plus masters moreover. Fine. Next thing is that language skill requirement. They will be also, you know, expecting you are very proficient in speaking the English. So if you are going to prove this, then you can make the following certificates as evidence, like TOEFL, IELTS, CAE, and you know, CPE all. Fine. So these are the some of their requirement. Okay, now if we follow further, basically, in addition to this, candidate must have a master degree in electrical engineering, computer engineering or equivalent. I told you, because of its interdisciplinary nature, it is not restricted only up to electronics engineering. You can't think like it is an integrated circuit, so only electronics candidate are going to be preferred. No. You can have either electrical engineering or computer engineering. And second, very important, the person or the fellow who are having experience in mixed analog or digital circuit design, they will be preferred. So if you have some prior hands-on, you know, analog or mixed IC designs at front end or back end, then you are going to be the suitable candidate for this profile. Is it clear? Right? Next is about the salary and condition. See, I already told you PhD candidate are remunerated in code 1017 and are normally remunerated at a gross for their respective currency 491,200 per annum before the tax. Although it may be negotiable or increased depending upon the high level of qualification and the research experience of the candidate. So this is just a, you know, base amount. It can be increased depend upon your research exposure and all. The period of the employment is 3 years, that I have told you already. Appointment to a PhD position required that you are admitted toward the PhD program in electronics and telecommunication within 3 months of the employment, and that you are participate in an organized PhD program during the employment period. Fine. Next, if we talk about its deadline, the application deadline is 30th of September 2021. Okay, so last day to apply for this course is this month till the date of 30th. Fine. So if you are looking really forward for this opportunity and you want to do your PhD and you want to explore the research opportunity in this domain, and which is really a, you know, well domain, because everybody wanted their device to be self-sustainable, as I have told you earlier. Many research have already done in this domain, but still a lot of potential is there to explore. So if you're looking for this opportunity, then you can check out this NTNU opportunity and move ahead with. Fine. Thank you.